Morning, Mr. Hammond. Your mission, should you choose to accept it?
Every writer knows about the call to adventure, or catalyst, or inciting event. It sets the story in motion, and it happens here. Blake Snyder says page 12 of a 110-page screenplay. But I think the slightly more accurate answer is the Act 1 midpoint. For example, 12.5 pages into a 100-page screenplay. Of all of story structure, it's the one beat everyone knows. The thing is, you've been lied to.
Titanic go to America in 5 minutes!
The call to adventure is not that important. It is not the beat that truly launches the hero's adventure. This is here.
You don't want to do this.
Right before the Act 1 break, a plot point will happen that forces your hero onto their journey. But what beat is that? I call it raising the stakes on the call to adventure. It's what I named this channel after. It's critically important, and it doesn't exist in any structure book. The only place I've seen it alluded to is page 128, paragraph 1 of Christopher Vogler's The Writer's Journey, which happens to be one of my all-time favorite books on structure. In my experience, both executives and screenwriters vastly overestimate the importance of this beat.
Your mission, Jim, should you choose to accept it.
And vastly discount, or are maybe unaware of, the importance of this beat. So today, we're going to talk about this beat, raising the stakes on the call to adventure. I'm Jonathan Stokes, and this is Raising the Stakes, Essays About Story. Let's get into it.
You must learn the ways of the Force if you're to come with me to Alderaan.
Luke Skywalker receives a call to adventure on page 12. The call is not super personal to Luke, and he turns it down because Joseph Campbell tells us heroes almost always initially refuse the call to adventure.
I can't get involved. Got work to do.
We can talk about that in another video. In this case,
there's nothing I can do about it right now.
So where's the raising the stakes beat? Here it is at the end of Act 1. Luke no longer has to worry about pleasing his aunt and uncle. They've been murdered by stormtroopers. Luke doesn't have to worry about farm chores. The farm is destroyed. Luke no longer has anything keeping him on Tatooine. Not only that, Luke is now on the run for his life, and the evil of the Empire is now very deeply personal to him. What was that call to adventure again?
You must learn the ways of the Force, if you're to come with me to Alderaan.
It was there on page 12, but it's so much more meaningful now on page 25. Thus, the stakes are raised on Luke's call to adventure.
Come with you to Alderaan. There's nothing for me here now. I want to learn the ways of the Force and become a Jedi like my father.
Jason Bourne's call to adventure is to answer the question, who am I? He's kind of just a guy with amnesia until he enters the American consulate at the end of Act 1 and discovers an entire army willing to kill him on sight. This adds a whole new level of urgency to Bourne discovering his identity. Buffalo Bill is a somewhat obscure serial killer until he abducts a U.S. senator's daughter at the end of Act 1, vastly raising the stakes of Clarice Starling's investigation. Michael Corleone resists joining the Mafia until his father is nearly murdered toward the end of Act 1. Only then does Michael realize he is the only person who can avenge his father. The murders Michael commits sends him on the run into his Act 2 journey of becoming the Godfather.
Then I'll kill them both.
Moana receives a call to adventure when a blight hits her island, destroying the food supply. She tries to leave the island to find new food, but her ship is not strong enough to escape the reef. But by the end of Act 1, it's not just about finding food. If Moana does not return the heart to Tafiti, not only will her island starve to death, but the entire world will be destroyed, stakes raised. Yes, the call to adventure is important. The audience needs to know the story is going somewhere. But if you begin the adventure on page 12, without going through all this, you will have a superficial story that quickly runs out of steam. My point in all these examples is to show how we writers, producers, and studio executives often overweight the value of the call to adventure on page 12. The true stakes of the call to adventure do not become apparent until the end of Act 1. Harry Potter's call to adventure is just to attend Hogwarts.
You're a wizard, Harry.
It's not until the end of Act 1 that Harry discovers he must learn wizardry in order to defeat Voldemort and save the world.
You're the boy who lived.
Armed with this knowledge, Harry can now go to King's Cross Station and board the train to Act 2. So if you find that your Act 1 isn't quite propelling the story into Act 2, look for this beat. This call to adventure is just a day off in Chicago.
I'm taking the day off. Now get dressed and come on over.
This.
That is why I have got to catch him this time. To show these kids that the example he sets is a first-class ticket to nowhere.
This makes it a movie.
Dad, you sounded like Dirty Harry just then.
Really?
Oh, you thought I was going to go a whole video without referencing Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade?
Find the man, and you will find the Grail.
You've got the wrong Jones, Mr. Donovan. Why don't you try my father?
We already have. Your father is the man who's disappeared.
Booyah.